What I really, really discovered at a very young age was the adventure of just exploring empty lots, and it was just a way to have an adventure. And I'm not sure it was wilderness as much it was just getting out on your own, being responsible for yourself, getting away from your parents, and just exploring, just trying to have an adventure. Climbing for me was just a very, very addicting activity, and I think it was the combination of the tribe, the physicality, the mental focus, and just the thought that you could go places you never thought possible. When you walk from Talkeetna a few hundred yards down to the Susitna River on a clear day and look up at the McKinley Range, there is McKinley, there is Hunter, and there is Foraker. Right in the middle is Hunter, and you are looking right at the southeast spur of the South Face. It's like the Walker Spur of the Alaska Range. It's one of the most elegant, beautiful lines. It was like a kasim. And seeing that on my first trip to Talkeetna in 1975, it left an indelible impression. And then realizing it had not been climbed, it was just something that begged to be climbed. It was such a beautiful and elegant line. I recognized the commitment, the risk involved, but had done everything in my power to spend two years training for this, getting as fit as possible, just stacking the deck in my favor. But I also recognized that that route was going to be very committing, and there is a whole array of objective dangers that were and are out of your control, and that you have to accept that death is one of the outcomes. In the previous year climbing the Alps, one of my climbing partners was killed. There was a need for me to accept the consequences of what I was doing, and to make sure that my parents and my family understood that I knew exactly what I was going to do, I knew what the risks were, and I fully accepted them because this was more important to me than anything else in my life. And it was worth taking that risk to do something this important to me. If we succeeded on this, it would clearly be the most important climb of our lives, at least up until that point. Hunter was a climb that I thought would take 6 days, and it took 13 days, and it pushed us to our absolute limits, and we succeeded because of that monomaniacal focus, that we were a really strong team. We broke it down into components, and we learned how to dig really deep and recognize that if we got through this day, we'd certainly get through the next day. Mount Hunter was one of those experiences that I would trade nothing in my life not to have had, and I would trade nothing in my life to repeat. You only have probably one of those in you. And then likewise, in starting Black Diamond, I had never started a business before, and it required the same level of commitment, leadership. It really was that experience in Hunter, the ability to dig deep, to motivate, in that case, a smaller team of people, to break a complex big climb into all the components. You know, that's exactly what it was about creating Black Diamond. I could say with confidence there would be no Black Diamond if I had not had that experience in Hunter.